Hi everybody, this is Sinisha from XOAP, and today I'm going to show you how to install the Package Wizard for the PowerShell App Deployment Toolkit. Let's do it! Okay, let's install the Package Wizard together. So, as a XOAP customer, the first thing you have to do is switch over to your workspace, click on Application Management, click on Applications, and search for Package. Here you can find the PowerShell App Deployment Toolkit-based package that you can download. It will have all the sources and a customized PowerShell App Deployment Toolkit framework package as well integrated. And just click Download to get the latest package. Today I will do the installation manually via the MSI to show you which steps are necessary to configure the package wizard. But if you run that package that I just downloaded, it will take care of everything. It will install the wizard, also copy over the latest framework, adjust the settings so that you can directly start with packaging installation packages. So let's switch over to my source folder, not the toolkit, but the package wizard, and just double click on that MSI. Let's click next. I will keep the installation location as it is. Install finished. All right, let's start it up. So, accept the license agreement, and now we will be directly transferred to the settings area. The first thing I have to do is point the package wizard to a toolkit. So, click on Browse. Wherever you stored it, I have it here in that location. And I just have to point it to the toolkit folder. Click on OK. And now our package wizard will go through the config XML file, show you all the options that you can configure, and you're now free to adjust everything here in the package wizard as you need it. And this configuration will be taken as a standard for every single installation package that you will be creating with the package wizard. The next step is to define a package library path, so the location where we will store all those packages that we create. Let's go here. I already created an empty folder on my C drive, so I will take this for the package. Click on Save. And that's everything we need to do. We can now flip over here to the packages area, right click and create a new package. And how that looks like, that's something I will show you in the next video. So thank you very much for watching. See you soon. Bye-bye.